Skip to here if you want the actual content of this video. Hi, for everybody else who's here for the intro section, welcome to a new series on this channel, which I'm going to call Today in Tiny Glade. And as a bit of background on why and what, in these videos, I will go through the Tiny Glade updates as they come out, and I'll show you what is new in this update and potentially, if I remember to do so, I will tell you what techniques that I've previously sold on this channel are affected by this update. And the reason for why I am doing this is quite simple. I made a Tiny Glade 101 video, which in its title sells itself as showing off all of the building interactions, building controls, building mechanics as they were intended in the game at the time of recording. However, the updates to the game have been so frequent that I am now posed with the problem of how to keep that video up to date despite weekly, bi-weekly, tri-weekly updates to the game. And you know, the only way that I can really ensure that that video stays up to date is by murdering the devs so that they stop updating the game. But because that's not an issue, sorry, because that's not an option, because that's not an issue, sorry, because that's not an option, I'll do this instead. So I'm going to have a new playlist on my channel, which I'm also going to try to push heavily on my Tiny Glade 101 video. And this playlist at the top is going to be Tiny Glade 101, and then it's going to be the rest of this series, so that somebody who has watched Tiny Glade 101 can then start going through the videos for each of the updates and see what has changed. And perhaps at some point, once we have reached some sort of critical mass of updates, perhaps then it's time to make a Tiny Glade 102 video and just take the first one offline. But until that day comes, in this interim between Tiny Glade 101 and a future Tiny Glade 102, this is what we'll be doing. We'll be looking at each update as it comes out in this new series, which I call Today in Tiny Glade. So Today in Tiny Glade, this is version 190C. We have gotten an update to freehand walls. So it's this tool, right? First icon, third one from the left. And previously, as we know, the wall would go up with the terrain, and so too would the arches. If I was to draw some path underneath here, the arches also kind of go up like this. However, there is now a new option present in the color palette when you use it on the freehand wall. And hovering over that option, you can see what it does. It makes all of the walls jump up to the same height. So it takes the highest point of the wall and it draws a line straight from there to the other end and gets everything nice and even at the top. So where previously, if you took a hill to build a castle on or whatever, and then you decided, all right, you know what, I want to put a little wall around this place just for my little garden area here, you would look at it and you'll be like, all right, great, fantastic, looks like, curse word, whatever. But now you can click this button and everything is nice and even at the top. So this is great for arcading. So I've previously talked about arcading in some of my more advanced videos where, you know, you can either work with blocks to do arcading or you can work with walls to do arcading. If none of this makes sense to you because you haven't seen those videos, don't worry about it. For everybody else who has seen those videos, you'll know what I mean. And you know, the trade-off with each would be that using blocks, you have the merlons at the top, which is a bit ugly, right? But you have easier controls with walls. You would have more difficult controls, but you would have a mostly even top without merlons. So, you know, I would grab my arches and then I'll pull the arches up, I'll pull the wall down, and that would look fine-ish. Well, now the trade-off isn't so steep anymore because we can do this now and give it a real flat top. Anyway, so this affects arcading, this also affects buttresses, because one thing that I accidentally already kind of teased there is that when you have the walls rectified like this, unified to a single height, if you pull this down lower than the arches are high, then you're going to get completely clean arches. So where previously with buttressing, we had to sort of see how we can fight this arch tool to get it clean at the top, and you know, you would mess around with a bit of path like this and you would have to overextend the wall a little bit, and that would get it mostly clean, or you would get terrain in on one side but not the other, and then you know, there was a whole lot of work just to get an arch without bricks at the top. Now it's no longer an issue. We just set that to that. And then as long as we keep the wall lower than the arch, it is clean. So, today in Tiny Glade, you can now unify, I suppose, the wall tool to one consistent top layer, as straight at the top as it gets. So with that, future videos in this series will hopefully be a bit shorter because I don't have to explain what this series is about a second time. Thank you for tuning in, and yeah, see you again soon, probably.